guys, this is Nagpal for iGAN.in, and today we're going to be unboxing and taking a look at the new Xperia Miro or Miro, however you like to call it. It's priced for a price of about 14,499 rupees or about 14,500 rupees in the Indian market. That's also approximately about 270 odd US dollars. It's available now in the retail market, so you can get it. For features, it has an 800 megahertz processor, a 3.5 inch touchscreen, and a 5 megapixel camera at the back. It also has a front facing 0.3 megapixel camera, which is more or less useless. It does come with Android ICS out of the box, and you have standard Sony Timescape user interface. So without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and unbox it. So a couple of things in the box. You have the standard Sony USB to micro USB cable. It's a fairly nice quality cable. Sony makes one of the best quality and best insulation cables. So these are really nice in quality, and they also have a static dump in the center over here, so that's good. Also in the box you will find Sony earphones. Now these are really high quality earphones. They do have a gold plated 3.5 millimeter connector and an inline microphone and push button. You also have in-ear ear tips over here and a nice Sony logo at the back. You do get additional tips, including a small size and a large size for all sorts of ears, and you do also get a lapel clip to connect these earphones to your collar. So we also have documentation. So this is SAR FCC statement. You also have, I guess this is warranty statement in German, Xperia Miro user information or a usage guide, which is also in German, surprisingly. So maybe I've got a German handset. Anyway, we've got some SIM card information in here as well. So it possibly uses a micro SIM card. So we've got a booklet on that. You have the new style Sony chargers. This is a fairly small charger with the Indian pin system, and you do have standard USB port on the side. Lastly, but most importantly, we have the Xperia Miro inside the box. This is the phone that you have been waiting to look at. So let's go ahead and rid of everything else, and I'll give you a quick hands-on with the phone. Okay, so this is the phone itself. Let me quickly get rid of this plastic packaging. Now, on the front of the phone, you will see the Sony logo along with the front-facing camera and a couple of sensors. Below that, you have a 3.5 inch capacitive touchscreen display. It's a disappointment because the resolution of the display is only HVGA, so that makes it 320 pixels by 480 pixels. However, it is a scratch resistant glass. It is a TFT LCD display. So you have three ICS sort of buttons at the bottom, the back button, the home button, and the menu button. You have this nice metallic chin, which has the Xperia logo on it. If you look at the right hand side, you have the volume rocker up top over here. If you look at the top of the device, you have the power lock and unlock button along with a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. On the left hand side, you have the micro USB charging and data syncing port, which is a standard video output. And on the bottom, you will see a lanyard connection point, which is over here, so you can attach a wrist strap or a charm or stuff like that. You also have a tappable at the back cover along with the microphone at the bottom. On the back, you will see a 5 megapixel autofocus camera along with an LED flash. You have the Sony mobile logo at the bottom along with the Xperia logo. And you also have the speakerphone grill, which is on the back cover over here. You have this nice matte finish back panel, which is white color. And if I remove the back panel, you will see the BA700 battery, which is pre-installed in the phone. This is a 1500 milliamp hour battery. So that's fairly large for the device. And you can see over here, you have the micro SD card slot along with a full-size SIM card slot, not a micro SIM like I thought previously. So let's quickly go ahead and power on the device. Hopefully it has enough charge for our quick demonstration. Okay, so this is the main screen of the device. It's the first time I'm powering it on, so it should come into language selection if nothing else. So I'll give it just about a couple of seconds for it to show up. So it does give English as an option. I'm going to quickly select that and move forward. Now you can see this is the Timescape user interface. We can scroll left or right in this system. I think they should have overview as well. So this is the overview feature where the widgets all come into the same screen. I can shake them around. That's really nice. If I pull down from the top over here, you have the notification panel. Also quick tab to jump to settings. You can see the new ice cream sandwich layout. If I jump into about phone, you'll see Android 4.0.4, that's ICS. That's fairly nice. Let me quickly connect to Wi-Fi over here. While it connects to Wi-Fi, I'll show you what the keyboard looks like. First, I'll go into the phone dialer. This is the phone dialer, new style phone dialer from Sony. Compared to what it was earlier when it was in Sony Ericsson, so this is a fairly newer style and it's nicer to look at, large keys and the background is clear and visible. You can jump into your groups or your contacts. You can also see the messaging screen is what I really wanted to show you, because of the simple fact that the keyboard is brilliant. It's got really nice and large keys over here with the new Sony style, and I can also have continuous input. If I go into text input settings, I should have gesture input as well, so I can enable that automatically, space between gestures. So the keyboard should work just brilliantly. I'll give it a quick test. While it said this is a Teddy, it also gave me an option for test. Because I'm doing it from the side, it is slightly difficult to do it from the angle that I'm doing it at. But you can see that it works just great, and I love the size of the keys. It's absolutely brilliant. You can also shift from portrait into landscape, and you get a nicer, wider format of the keyboard. Let me quickly jump back out. There is a video in there, a couple of videos in fact. So let me play this one. You can see video playback is fairly smooth. That's a pretty high res video over there. However, the quality of the screen is HVGA. I don't seem to see any sort of pixelation in the screen, so that's good. Hopefully it does have the Bravia engine on it. I'm not too sure because it doesn't give me that option anywhere. So it is a fairly nice display. It's very vivid. I'm going to quickly jump into the browser over here and see if I can open up a website without inserting a SIM card. So you're trying to open up igan.in. It should load up the full website. If you need to go to the mobile website, you can visit m.igan.in. However, you can see that it loads up the full website without any issues. We have made a couple of changes, including changing the background from gray to white. So that looks nice on this display. As you can see, it's loading up the full website without any issues over here. All of the latest news you can browse through. It's fairly smooth. It's pretty smooth. It's really nice and easy to scroll through the screen. Again, pinching and zooming in is also pretty fast. Again, not the best that we can get. Nothing like Windows Phone or higher end Android phones, but it's fairly good. You can see it loads up the full website. If I shift into landscape, again, it should shift into landscape. Nice, simple animation. Again, scrolling is fairly smooth. No issues with that. I'll also quickly load up a video from YouTube to show you how a video streaming is on this. Again, you can expect only good iGAN stuff. So let me quickly jump to iGAN and see what I can find. iGAN video. The Nike Plus Fuel Band is going to be launched in India in a couple of weeks, and we don't have the exact date right now, but Nike says that it... So you can see how smooth that was. It plays video almost brilliantly. The audio also is absolutely loud and stunningly clear. So really appreciate that in this device. The display seems to be fairly crisp. I'm going to be coming back with a full review of this device really soon, so stay tuned for that. Do visit igan.in for the full featured details on this device, and you can check us out on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, and make sure you subscribe to us on YouTube, youtube.com/igan, youtube.com/igan TV. But iGAN Network is doing well, not well. Thank you guys for